come for the Kathak conference, the Kathak came. The most relevant and the most authentic version of the speaking came from her and from Rohini Kathak. These were the two Kathak exponents who practiced and researched Prayog or Shastra. दोनों को साथ लेकर के चलते थे. Very few Kathak exponents in those days bothered about the Shastras. There were two different ways. One was the practitioners, the one was the Shastra here. But these brought them together. As far today's subject goes, I welcome all my panelists. You have seen them all. They are all well versed in their own fields. Legacy, realignment, and transition. Mere vichar se, Maya, Madhu, company, our trust, jiski kal sthapna hui hai, usse behtar is subject ka koi udharan ho hi nahi sakta. Maya represents the legacy that has come from Natya Shastra, Bharat Muni, till late. And the realignment, you have seen the perfection, with such perfection, this whole seminar is choreographed. We have seen well-conceived, well-executed seminar, but not well-choreographed seminar. शुरू से अभी तक एक मिनट का भी ऐसा अंतराल नहीं आया जब हमारी आंखें स्पेस से हटी हों या हमारा ध्यान कहीं और गया. Congratulations, Madhu. But taking up such people from very beginning, from the Anita and you yourself, हम आपको बताना चाहते हैं कि लेगेसी किस तरह से इस लड़की ने जोड़ी. लड़की कहने के लिए माफ करना. आप वहां देख रहे हैं जर्जर नाट्य शास्त्र में वर्णित जर्जर वो गणेश जी है जो हर तरह के दुख, हर तरह के अनिष्ट को दूर करता है. सबसे पहले मंच पर वो स्थापित था और पूर्व रंग की तरह आप सब के आने के पहले अगर व्यक्ति की पावन सुगंध से पूरा ये परिसर सुगंधित किया गया, कॉन्सेंट्रेटेड किया गया, दैट इज द लेगेसी. She is continuing till date with full bhakti bhavana. And the competence of today's, the latest technology. Kisi ko kehna nahi pada ki volume badhao ya ghatao, ya roshni idhar karo ya udhar. Ek baar Shambhu Maharaj se, kyunki Maya Rao guru the, us zamane mein light aisi nahi hua karti thi. Light wala baithta tha, neele peele lal kagaz lagata tha. To usne Maharaj se pucha, Maharaj कौन सा कागज लगाऊं, लाल रंग लगाऊं कि पीला रंग लगाऊं. वो खड़े हुए, तू मुझे रंग देगा? मेरा रंग मेरी कला है. तो उस लेगेसी को कथक बिलोंग करता है और मैं आप में से प्रत्येक का स्वागत कर रही हूँ यहाँ पे. सबसे पहले आप सब अलग अलग जगहों पर बहुत अच्छा काम कर रहे हैं. You have preserved the legacy and you are expected to realign it with the present times to transit it to the next generation. So, I would like to ask you three of you, what kind of difficult situation you have made this legacy be maintained and realignment be a perfect transition. One by one, all of you.
Thank you, Madhu, for making me part of this conversation and this wonderful day. I have been greatly influenced when I used to listen to Maya Didi talk about the legacy of Shambhu Maharaji and his purvas. Yeah. Right from the word of Namaskar, she would say, Shambhu Maharaj Ji would say, I believe, that when you do namaskar to me, it's not to me, but it's to the entire legacy. You're offering your pranams. I very much remember that, and every time, even when my disciples touch my feet, the first thing is it goes through like a conduit through me to all the Purujas. And I tell this to the students that this should be the attitude with which you should come, learn, and be influenced by this legacy. First, pranam, and the feeling with which goes. Yes, another aspect of Maya Didi was, like she said, courage, courage ke le rahi. And what she was observing, that a lot of changes happening even during Shambhu Maharaj's time and whatever she was learning, but she was so much engrossed to find the roots of those things, the origins, and what went through the metamorphosis, and is there any possibilities to bring those things back if we have lost any? That's the second point. And I was part of even learning the Chaturang, and similarly Tripats and the Prabhandas, which she is the person who revived and brought it back as a repertoire of Kathak. That is bringing the legacy back. And that's what I would like to first train my disciples to learn these things. And then once you have imbibed them, it has become a natural, instinctive, intuitive movements in you. Then you can graduate to improvise within the grammar of the dance form. I think that's passing on the legacy. Thirdly, I remember Didi was always saying, and as it was mentioned, that there should be a relevance of the nritya when it is interspersed in the nritya aspect, which I had observed even when she was choreographing ballets or even bhajans and tumris, that the footwork had purposeful interpolation in the sahitya to bring out that expression, which I try to incorporate in my choreographic works and I teach my students. And I think that is taking things forward in the name of legacy.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Bhari, you are working out, I mean, not in India. You are taking our arts in the global perspective. What are the challenges that you are facing to keeping up the legacy and realigning it to the present generation of the foreigners?
Matiji, the biggest problem I have is that cultural differences that are there, not just culturally, religious, nationalities, the communities are different, the age and experience of people are different. So realignment is almost synonymous with presentation. Every now and then we've got to mold it and make it acceptable and understood. The mission is to say something, to be understood, to hear the audience, and then create rasa with the rasik. Unless there is a reciprocity that is maintained within the audience. In fact, most of our performances, we have some lights on in the audience as well, so that we can see what's happening in the audience, how they're receiving us. Because every audience is different. Same audience is different in a different time. So it's almost like poetry. You read a piece of poetry, in the morning it means something else, and by evening it's something else. So we as presenters have to reword it from the very beginning and mold ourselves. It becomes very difficult with recorded music because everything is digitally arranged and organized with laser lighting. The areas where you have to sit and stand are also fixed. So these are the modern challenges that we have. Having said that, the only thing that works is verbalization. We verbalize our technique in a way that it is understood. So using the correct alignment of the thought, the spoken word, and the action, aligning all the three, only then we are understood. So that is a formula that Guruji gave to us, and I'm taking it forward.
Dosto, Pali ki jo problem hai, main aapke saath share karna chahti hu. वंशी का नाम ले लेगी हमारे दिमाग में कृषि की छवि रहती है. हमारे पास एक सांस्कृतिक इतिहास she is saying ki wahan pe ye samjha pa rahi hai ek mushkil kaam hota hai. And glad you're working hard on that. What about you? First of all, let me compliment the thehrao of the Bada Khayal was actually you. Bada Khayal ko unhone nahi kiya tha. Unhone dheeme lehre pe kiya tha. Aapne Chaudhuri ke Bada Khayal pe kiya tha. Sabse pehle aapko badhai de rahi hu isliye. आपके लिए सबसे बड़ा चैलेंज है कि इस तरह की ठहराव भरी लेगेसी को आगे ट्रांसमिट करना, इसको कैसे रियलाइज करते हैं?
ये तो बहुत बड़े चैलेंज है, बिकॉज़ व्हाट हैपेंस इज टुडे ऑल द पीपल हु सी कथक थिंक कथक इज ऑल अबाउट चक्कर्स एंड फुटवर्क एंड इट्स ऑल एक्रोबैटिक्स व्हिच आई फील दैट इट्स आल्सो देयर इन सर्व दिस ऑल. So why would they want to? So there has to be, they need to be educated that there is something which is beyond just footwork and chakras. Yes, it was important. It's a form. It's a the purity of the form has to be maintained. But the thehrao is, you know, even this came right from even Damayanti Didi when she used to teach, you know, Dhirubhaiya. We have seen her teaching him. And that's when we have, just by observing and listening to them also, you learn a lot as to what is the importance of a thehrao in the whole dance, that the body line has to be seen. It shouldn't be in a glimpse you have lost the whole body line, that the whole postures, there is a beauty which is coming out from the body and not from just the bowl. The bowl are your support. Your body should be responding and dancing rather than the bowls making you dance. So I feel that's the major realignment which I need to get into the students or even whoever I'm trying to teach. Now what happened is, after his untimely passed away, it was such a shock to all of us. I mean, there were only a few students. We all stopped dancing. It was out of shock that we stopped dancing, and unfortunately, I did not start learning from anybody else, because I thought, no, I cannot learn from anybody else, this particular angle, especially when we had learned. And I just did not, I dwindled off, and thanks to Madhu, actually, I should tell her, she kept on saying that, no, you can't do this, I mean, you have to restart your dance. And you have to restart and come back and, you know, preserve what he's done all these years. And who else would try to show this? People should know that this existed. And this is also a dance form. So yeah, that's a big challenge.
Look, any dance form, the vocabulary is your vocabulary to communicate yourself. So you are saying that you should express yourself from your body. वही शरीर एक्सप्रेस कर सकता है जो कि कथक की टेक्निक में दीक्षित हो. एक बार हजारी प्रसाद द्विवेदी ने कहा था कि परंपरा क्या चीज है, आप पहला पैर जमाइए, जब तक आपका पहला पैर जमा हुआ नहीं होगा अगला पैर आप उठा नहीं सकते, आप पैर लगा नहीं होंगे. तो सबसे पहली चीज जरूरी है अपनी तकनीक पर पूरा अधिकार. इतना अधिकार के वो अधिकार पा करके आप यू गो बियॉन्ड टेक्निक टू एक्सप्रेस योरसेल्फ. तो इस संदर्भ में हमारे यहाँ कहा गया है पुराण नृत्य वन साधु सर्वम, जो कि पुराना है वो सब सही है, कोई जरूरी नहीं है. न चापि काव्यम नवमितवेद्यम, न जो आज कहा जा रहा है वही सही है. संत परीक्षां तरतप बदन्ते मूढ़ पर प्रत्येक बुद्धि, जो पुराना कहा गया है लेगेसी में जो कुछ है वो आज के युग में उतना सच सब कुछ नहीं हो सकता है, और आज जो कुछ कंटेम्प्रेरी चल रहा है वो हो सकता है लेगेसी से मैच ना करता हो. तो आप अपनी प्रक्रिया में लेगेसी को रखते हुए रियलाइनमेंट की प्रक्रिया में क्या रखना चाहते हैं और क्या छोड़ना चाहते हैं? ये बहुत निरक्षीर विवेक की बात है. हम लोग सरस्वती की वंदना करते हैं, सरस्वती का वाहन जो हंस है उसकी खासियत है चोंच डालते ही वो पानी अलग कर देता है, दूध अलग कर देता है और दूध दूध दे देता है, पानी छोड़ देता है. आज इतना कुछ बिखरा पड़ा है, नेट पे जाइए, यूट्यूब पलाना ठिकाना, मतलब आदमी दिमाग पगला जाए इतना कुछ है, उसमें से क्या लेना है और क्या छोड़ना है कि लेगेसी की सार्थकता, उसकी ऊर्जा, उसका सत्व, उसकी इथॉस बरकरार रहे और फिर भी आप कंटेम्पररी टाइम से जुड़े हैं.
To answer this, I think I have to recapitulate a couple of incidents in the life of Didi. I believe that once during a session, there were some guests sitting before Shabu Maharaji, and they made a sniggering comment that, what Maharaji, you've been doing the same old stuff. Gopi aate hain, matka laate hain, they go to the river, and then we have been seeing this umpteen million zillion times. Can't you contemporize something about it? Why should you repeat the same thing? But then I think, I'm not sure, but I think he found another opportunity and asked them, you come back, and then I'm going to contemporize specially for you. So the guest came on another occasion, and then he said, okay, bring the plastic bucket here, and then you see, imagine there's a null here. Go near the null and open it, and then take, draw water from the null and go. So when this was attempted to be enacted, it was unaesthetic even for the guests to watch. But then he made them, he said, okay, no contemporizing, please, please, keep, bring back the original content. Maharaji said, it's not just movement, it's not just a beautiful enactment across the stage and space, but there is esoteric meaning attached to every concept which has withstood the test of time. If it has not withstood the test of time and reasoning and spiritual awakening and connection with that, it would not have continued as a legacy. So it is necessary that we understand that and continue and pass it on. Whether it is relevant to the 21st century or not, but the grandeur is there when you bring back the old glory back onto the stage. So I am a very firm believer of keep intact our traditional legacy compositions. But you can, to a certain extent, deviate to bring back modern thoughts and concepts, or even to the sensibilities of the modern audience. I would like to narrate a very small anecdote. I went to Norway, and then I was about to present my performance in Kathak, and when I took a stance of Krishna with the typical hand movements or did Ghungar, nobody in the audience understood what it was. I was going through with my legacy, whatever I learned. But they were not sensitive or sensible enough to understand the mudras. Because in India, children grow up watching all this and they without telling them. But then I realized these people have no exposure about India, and they still thought I would come on stage with colors on my face, with a snake in my baggage or a peacock feather stuck in my hair, and I would speak English. Was a big surprise thing for them. So it was a failure for me, and the next day I was taken by my hostess to a grip island, and I came to know the story behind that island, where there was a church on top of the mountain, and an old man had warned the village fishermen that they should escape a possible storm and should come and pray in the church. Many did not listen to him, so some of them went. The storm came, the entire village was washed up, and the people in the church survived. They said thanks to God, and they gave up that island to that church. Now, when I heard this, I thought, yes, contemporizing. I think I'm going to narrate this story of theirs to them through my idiom of Indian dance, Kathak. So next, I had no costume, I had no special music, no stagecraft, no special lighting, no nothing practically, except for my lehra machine and ghungrus on my feet. But the art of expression through the medium of grammar and medium of Kathak, I could convey their story. And at the end of it, there were a lot of people coming and appreciating, but especially one lady with tears in her eyes. She said, how beautiful you did it, how expressive your hands are, your movements are, so subtle, delicate, and do you know, you unfolded the entire scenario of the tragedy before my eyes, and I was one of those who was in the church. So if you can make your audience feel what you are trying to express through their own personal experiences in life,
That's he's
wonderful.
Saying, he did it with the legacy he had in himself. कि लोगों के परिचय बहुत जल्दी पढ़ दिए जाते हैं. Maybe that one of some of you may have missed it. You're the only person who has studied under Maya Didi. तो इनके आप तो वचन के अंदर वो अनुभूज है. आप बताएं, what you, how do you carry on this?
Manji, I feel educating the dancer and expecting the dancer to choose what the dancer wants to be. A dancer, an instructor, or a designer, or art administration person, they should categorically know what they can't be everything. You can't just learn dance and be a very good teacher and a perfect choreographer and an artistic director, everything. You can be everything when you have the experience of everything. Then you can be. But in the beginning itself, if you come with your red glasses on, that today I'm going to be this and tomorrow that, and day after palta leke I'll become something else, it doesn't happen. So we as instructors should, as gurus, give them the guideline, give them the choices, give them the right to make the right decision, and then put the responsibility on them that now that you chose to do this, darling, pull up your socks and do it. And then we expect, we also as dancers need to educate our audiences. And we want them to be educated because we want to do better work. And we need people to understand us, because otherwise the dance is there and we think there and we are nowhere. And it's very frustrating when you don't, when you're not able to say what you really want to say because you, your audience is not with you. So the level of rasa that you want to create depends on reciprocity and correct education. Have the choices, and yes, today the generations are spoiled for choices, but we as the older generation have to give them the right to make a decision and give them the responsibility to fulfill that particular choice that they've made.
Best of luck. Keep it up.
And since going back to your question as to what to take from the legacy and what not to merge, you know,
yes.
I feel it's very important for all of us that you've learned a particular style, you've learned from various gurus. For example, even Viru Bhaiya also learned from Vandana Singh and from Gopiji and from Damayanti. But what was essence is that what suits your body? What is going to you know, look good on your body? That particular style you need to imbibe from all this.
Very
body.
Important point.
Yeah, because it's, you cannot try and replicate whatever they have done. Like Gopi ji ka jo style tha, wo Gopi ji pe hi suit hota tha. You try to replicate that, you will look like something different. I mean, it won't. Similarly, so he also taught us that even when I am teaching you, you take what is good for you. And I feel that's what I have been trying to even tell my whoever I've been teaching, that it's important that you need to observe what looks good on your body, what fits good on your body. Like you go and, you know, try out a kurta or a dress which fits good on someone, might look good on someone and not look good on you. Similarly, dance is also a language which has to be, you know, individualized, I feel.
That's a very important point. Nowadays, there is a fashion, rather necessity, of teaching on Skype. What's your idea about that? All of you. Art like ours, Jyoti Art of Bhakti Parampara se Guru Shishya Parampara se aya hai. Isme har guru dekh paata hai kisko kya suit karega jo banta hai, uske hisab se usko sikhata hai. Ya wo khada hua hai to uska balance sahi nahi. एक बात बताई थी किसने, रोहिणी जी ने, या हमारे ख्याल से कुमुदी जी ने बताई थी कि जब दक्षा आके खड़ी हुई तो उन्होंने सबसे पहले कहा कि तुम्हारी एक चप्पल घिस गई है, अपनी चप्पल बदलो. तो गुरु शिष्य परंपरा का ये कमाल होता है कि गुरु माइन्यूटिस थिंग एंड यू ही नोटिसेस एंड इंस्ट्रक्ट्स यू अकॉर्डिंगली. तो आज जबकि गुरु शिष्य परंपरा में सीना वसीना तालीम जिसे कहते हैं, वो उसमें आप यकीन करते हैं या स्काइप में करते हैं, या कैसे दोनों के बीच में गुजारा करते हैं?
Well, I have seen produced many clippings of Pali ji, and I really admire her wonderful work in a short, crisp, neat, but very communicating. Why I'm talking about this, yes, Skype and such clippings are excellent tools of teaching technique at the basic level, at the fundamentals, at the, to understand the grammar of that particular art form. Yes, which is a must. So in the absence, because of geographical distances and time changes, these will help, including the Skype. But there must come a stage in the development that there is person-to-person contact becomes a must to, like you said, Kundalini Mukherjee could be able to identify the minor aspect. So I am that kind of person who says a one-on-one is a must in the field of performing arts. And it's not the instructions we take and perform, but it is sitting at the feet of your guru and then, you know, being in her ambience, in her aura, you get to learn a lot.
Learning through the internet, online, Skype, all the other ways of learning other than actually going to the Gurukul or going to your teacher's place are just supplements. They are like vitamins. They're just a reminder. People are thinking, oh, I will dance, and oh, maybe I've seen it. Maybe now I should go to my teacher. So every lesson that I have put up, there's always a reminder for people to go and connect so that more people are involved. More people get work. Art as a school develops and many other people are engaged in the activity. I don't think you can learn dance through online, although I have been promoting this. But every lesson has this reminder that go and connect with someone who's inspired you.
How do you manage that?
We have emails that they come to us and every time we just say it, we run other programs. And there are people who are commissioned to answer each and every email. They are fully employed into this, that's their job. And they want to ask us where to go, we give them options. Sometimes due to financial issues or there are some societies where people are not allowed to dance for some reason, then we send them separate classes specifically for them, or we invite them. We get other people to fund their travel, keep them at home, as much as we can, or we say, you know what, this gentleman is teaching there, would you go and contact him? He will charge you 20% of what he normally charges. So many people are getting work. Learning through Skype as a beginner is very difficult, almost impossible, because then you have to root the plant the right way. But advanced classes, you can. Personally, I feel that's easier because you already know how to stand like a dancer. If you can't stand, it takes time to stand like a dancer, a long time to stand like a dancer. So I feel beginners is just a reminder, what I've kick-started, but the aim is to go to someone and be in their sharan. If you light an agarbatti, inhale it, then learn.
There are gurus available there?
Many, many. Many of them are there, but they're not coming out as gurus. They've learned something somewhere. So if nothing else, we have a good audience that we. People are getting aware. If everybody is not going to be a dancer, I don't know when I will be a dancer, but the irony is that everybody thinks, when I become this, then I will share. I don't have time. You have to share now. You took it then, you've been sitting with it for a while, now pull up your socks and do it.
So patient is that?
Because she told me I have 45 seconds. I'll just say one word. I'm constantly looking there and she said 1 minute. Now 1 minute is going to 45 seconds. I've already used 40 seconds. So I would just say I'm an old school. Sina Pasina thing. Yes, that's about it. Thank you. Now.
Thank you. आपने जो बात कही थी कि जाकर के चर्च की स्टोरी को इतनी अच्छे से बयान कर पाए वो इसलिए कर पाए कि किसी माया दीदी जैसी गुरु की शागिर्दी में उन्होंने वो तकनीक सीख ली थी कि कैसे बात को कहा जाए Kathak is an art of a storyteller. You can tell any story around its technique. So, any questions from you people? Are there any? Is there any time for questions?
कला के भूखे जरूर हैं. सो जस्ट आई एम वेरी इंटरेस्टेड इन दिस आइडिया दैट व्हाट डू वी कीप ऑफ द लेगेसी एंड व्हाट डू वी लीव. सो एवरीबडी टॉक्ड अबाउट व्हाट वी आर कीपिंग बट आई वांट टू हियर व्हाट इज इट दैट यू आर परहैप्स लीविंग इफ एनीथिंग.
कैन आई आंसर दैट
प्लीज.
मुझे ऐसा लगता है कि जब पुराने ज़माने में चीज़ें बनी थी तब हवा दूसरी थी, खाना ऑर्गेनिक था आई थिंक, और इतने स्ट्रेस एंड स्ट्रेन्स नहीं थे, इतनी जद्दोजहद नहीं थी. अब टाइम्स हैव चेंज्ड, वी आर ईटिंग कैंड एंड फ्रोजन फूड, वी आर लिविंग इन एन एनवायरनमेंट वेयर एयर इज वी ऑफन हैव टू गो फॉर ऑक्सीजन एंड थिंग्स लाइक दैट. सो व्हाट वी कांट डू नाउ इज behave and act like we did. Our body alignment has changed, our needs have changed. So we need to do a specific kind of warm up and specific kind of cool downs, and these are some of the things that are necessary in our training. What to take is to continue to graft them, graft your movement in such a way that are based on the legacy that you have. But they have to be aligned to a modern body. We all want to be zero size and all that stuff. So with all those pressures, we have to be alert of what we are eating, what we are drinking, how much are we drinking, how are we drinking, how are we sitting. There's so many other things that perhaps at that time people didn't think, because ghee khate the or laddu khate the. Abhi to hum ek-ek calorie ginte hain. So what we are taking is what we have, but what we are giving is we are realigning it to our needs and then perhaps giving.
थैंक्यू
जी. ने यह सवाल पूछा था, इस पर मुझे एक बात याद आ गई. रात को इतनी खूबसूरत एक हिंदी बोल रही थी, हमने कहा आप इतनी अच्छी हिंदी और कनाडा में रहते हुए. बोले जब मैं पहली बार अपने गुरु के पास गई तो उन्होंने कहा कथक सीखने से पहले तुम्हें हिंदी सीखनी पड़ेगी. और इस बात पर एक और बात मैं एक ऑब्जर्वेशन शेयर करना चाहती हूँ. जस्ट कमिंग फ्रॉम ए सेमिनार एट द एनसीपीए व्हिच वाज हेल्ड एंड देयर वर थ्री पीपल रिप्रेजेंटिंग उदय भावलकर Dhrupad, Ashwini Bhide Khayal, and Sunanda Sharma Thumri. And they were telling about their hardships and how to come on that. So Sunanda Sharma ne jo baat batai hum aapse share karna chahte hain, ho sakta hai kathak ke prasang mein bahut mufeed ho. Unhone kaha jab hum Girja Devi ke paas gaye to hum to Punjab ki ladki the, hur hur gala chalta tha. To unhone kaha ki ye nahi chalega. संज्ञा गए विस्थान अगर तुम कह रही हो या नाव धीरे चलाओ तो इतनी जोर से करोगे तो नाव तो पलट जाएगी. यू हैव टू इरेज ऑल दिस हरकत फ्रॉम योर वॉइस देन ओनली यू कैन से पूरा टन. एंड सेकंड थिंग उन्होंने कहा कि खाना सीखो. तो उन्होंने कहा ठीक है, हम तो गाना सीखने आए थे, खाना सिखा रहे हैं. तो उन्होंने ये बताया कि देखो सब चीज़ में प्याज लहसुन का तड़का नहीं चलेगा. जहाँ हींग का छौंक लगाना है वहाँ लहसुन तो दिखा भी नहीं सकते. तो ये बारीक बातें हैं. उस्ताद असद अली खान ने एक बार हमसे कहा था, आजकल लोग बजाते बजाते आप देखते हैं कि सितार और सरोद जहाँ ज़्यादा पहुँचता है कण कटु हो जाता है, झेलना मुश्किल हो जाता है. तो उन्होंने कहा था अंजलि जी, सुर की कमर इतनी नाजुक होती है कि वो मजराब का बोझ भी बर्दाश्त नहीं कर सकती. तो आप सबको हमारी हार्दिक शुभकामनाएं हैं. ये बहुत रिच लेगेसी है, इसको हम पूरी प्रामाणिकता के साथ, पूरी गरिमा के साथ आगे ले जाएं. आज के युग से समझौता करें, पर ऐसा नहीं कि कथक ही न रह जाए. धन्यवाद.
दीदी एक मिनट मंजरी दीदी थैंक यू सो मच दिस इज सच अमेजिंग पैनल एंड आई कुड रिलैक्स एंड लिसन बिकॉज माइन वाज ओवर सो आई जस्ट वांटेड टू से समथिंग अबाउट नागराज ने कहा जो तो नागराज आई थिंक द स्टोरी वाज अ लिटिल डिफरेंट एज वी रिमेंबर इट व्हाट हैपेंड इज बलराज सानी वॉकड इन टू महाराज जीज क्लास एंड सेड व्हाई इज इट दैट योर गोपीज आर हमेशा गोइंग टू द पनघट हमेशा पानी लेने क्यों जाती हैं तो महाराज जी ने कहा कि ये जो जमुना नदी है दैट इज़ द रिवर ऑफ लाइफ और हर एक गोपी अपने मटके में शी गोज टू टेक अ शेयर ऑफ अ लाइफ एंड वेन द कॉल ऑफ द फ्लूट और द हरकतें ऑफ कृष्णा दे हैव टू बी सीन एज अ हायर कॉल अ स्पिरिचुअल कॉल दैट डिस्ट्रैक्ट्स हर फ्रॉम द मंडेन एंड देन ही सेड इफ यू वॉन्ट समथिंग न्यू देन आई कैन मेक देम लाइन अप इन फ्रंट ऑफ अ Nali and you know just with plastic buckets so that was what the story was I think we used to listen to these anecdotes and I think over time we sort of forget so I just thought I want you to relate it again so I thought I'll just tell you I hope you don't mind
no I don't mind at all
is this zyada khoobsurat is sabha ka samapan ho nahi sakta tha hamari sari kalaen physical se spiritual level tak le jane ki kalaen ho bhautik se aadhyatmik tarah tak le jane ki kalaen ho और वही उनका साथ दे रही है और उनकी सिद्धि भी धन्यवाद
थैंक यू मंजरी जी
अंत में मेरी हिंदी झेलने के लिए शुक्रिया
थैंक यू सो मच फॉर दैट एंगेजिंग एंड थॉट प्रोवोकिंग कॉन्वर्सेशन